What are you doing in here?
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our first unboxing of random crap.
I really have no idea what to call this. It's basically a haul video, so let's call it that.
Since the votes were pretty much unanimous on whether or not I should show off the goodies that I find when I go on my little, shall we say, expeditions of gaming goodness. Now, this isn't gonna exactly be a regular thing. I mean, anytime I find something cool, I'll definitely share it with you guys. Even if it's not cool, I'll share it with you guys. If I find something, I'll share it with you guys. Whenever I find something cool, that's when a video will show up. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So, I'll start off with what I picked up on Saturday. The contents of this box, I actually picked all of this up for $20 at a local swap meet. Now, don't get too excited. It's mostly crap. Most of the stuff I really didn't want. I mean, a USB. That's not a USB cable. I'm gonna have to find out what that's all about. Like I was saying, most of the stuff in here didn't really catch my eye. It's like, '70s stopwatch. It's futuristic because it's digital. A Sega RF switch? Because there was some Sega stuff. So, an old speaker. Crap. Anybody need a Sony Boomerang? Link cable. I think. It's a crappy one. It's crap. Go home, adapter cable. You're drunk. Why do we need a vacuum tube? Alright, now we're getting to the good stuff. Like, well, good is subjective, but when was last time you saw a trackball mouse for the Super Nintendo? If I remember correctly, because it's all sticky. If I remember correctly, this was particularly for Mario Paint, which I could get if I was desperate to add to my collection, but I'll keep it around anyway. Basically a second gen Game Boy. I mean, it's the original Game Boy internally, but they started giving them fancy colors in the mid-90s, so an odd gimmick, but a gimmick nonetheless. Who knows, I might actually start collecting one of each color just for shits and grins, because I already have an actual original Game Boy. You may already notice that it's missing the little bezel thing that goes around the screen, but those are actually pretty easy to find replacements for, so it shouldn't be too hard to get this guy looking nice and spiffy. And of course, there's a it's a little beat up, it looks like, but maybe it'll still work. But we have a SNES controller here. Could never have too many of those, maybe, I don't know. There were a couple of games for the Genesis. We have Shanghai Dragon's Eye, which I'm pretty sure is a just a fancy name for Mahjong. Which, don't get me wrong, when you're really bored and have no internet, Mahjong is a fun game. And then there's Toys the Game. Did you ever see the movie starring Robin Williams? It was weird. Of course, it's not exactly a
an actual Sega brand, but it's a Genesis controller. And since I have a couple of Genesis games that I might want to play, assuming that they work, I'd like to have a Genesis controller to use with them, since they'll work in my Retron 5, and it accommodates for the original controllers. That's a little feature that I like to utilize. And last but not least, an original NES. Now, I know it's probably not all that impressive to some people, but I'm a man who likes to tinker. And if it doesn't work, I'd like to see if I can get it to work. And if I can get it to work, assuming that it doesn't, I'd like to see if I can do one of those HDMI mods that I've been seeing on the interwebs of late. I don't know, it sounds like fun to me. Then Sunday, depending on your point of view, was either less exciting or more exciting. Because while I was out in Tacoma, I decided to check out the local swap meets. There were a few booths scattered around the place that had games and game consoles for sale. I just didn't pull the trigger on any of them this week. So, if the things I had my eye on aren't there next time I go, it wasn't meant to be. But after I left there, I went down the street to one of my new favorite gaming shops. After a bit of rummaging, I found one title that I got to re-add to my collection. Now, Alleyway is not that impressive of a game for most people, but I liked it, so I wanted it back. Then I figured, if I'm going to start getting Sega Genesis games, I may as well get a popular title. So I picked up a copy of Sonic the Hedgehog as well. I don't know, I've never owned a Sega system other than the Game Gear that my dad got bored with and let me have. Anyway, there's also a interesting little story that happened while I was at the game store. A guy walks in, and as he passes by, I kind of thought I recognized him. Wasn't quite sure. But eventually I found out that it was who I thought it was. I ran into Radical Reggie. And if you don't know who that is, shame on you. No, just kidding. He's a local YouTuber who collects rare games and imports. He's been featured multiple times on John Riggs' channel and The Metal Jesus. And if you don't know who they are either, check them out. If you like the old school games, if you like learning about gaming history, check them out. That's all I can say. But yeah, I actually met another YouTuber, and despite the fact that I told myself that I would never fanboy if I met another YouTuber that I more or less admired. Yeah, I mean, I think I was cool and calm, but on the inside I was like, oh my gosh! I wouldn't be in the least bit surprised if he was thinking to himself, this little white boy is stupid. Nah, he's a really nice guy, and I'm glad I got to meet him. And it actually made me start thinking that
I hope that I can be half as cool and chill as he was if I end up in that situation. Probably won't happen for a long time, but who knows? I don't know if this is a interesting story to you guys, but I felt like sharing because it's something that happened that I thought was pretty cool, and in a weird sort of way, it was kind of inspiring. I mean, here's a guy, just a regular Joe, just like me, doing something he loves and sharing it with the world. And our paths crossed at just the right time to where we'd meet and talk and chill out for a second. We were still two regular guys, but we had... This is starting to sound really weird. I'd better stop before I start sounding like a psycho creeper. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give that like button a bop. Leave a comment down below. And I will see you in the next video. Hopefully, it'll amaze.